Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Actually, I am representing IST. Actually, Professor Ranjit Singh was supposed to be here, but due to some earlier schedule and some earlier commitment, he was not able to make it up. So I am representing IST only, and this present whatever presentation is there, it is of him only. The Higher Education Summit for the year, we are I am just representing Indian Society for Technical Education. Let me introduce Indian Society of Technical Education, what at all it is doing, and how we can be a part of this, this revolution. How can we be a factor which can play some roles there? Now, Indian Society for Technical Education is a national professional non-profit making society registered under the Society Registration Act. Earlier, it was formed in 1941. In the name of Association of Principals of Technical Institution, which has been rechristened in 1968 in the name of Indian Society for Technical Education. The major object is to assist and contribute in the production and development of top quality professional engineers and technicians needed by the industries and other organizations. And being the only national organization of education in the field of engineering and technology, IST effectively contributes in various missions of Union government, and it's a very strong linkages with Ministry of HRD, AICT, DST, other state government agencies. As for the aims and objectives are concerned, a major objective is to help the students in personal development and the faculty members in career development, which is needed by the institution, industries, and other organizations at national and international levels. The major objectives of the IST are to formulate the general goals and responsibilities of technical education. Okay. Modify curriculum education process to changing conditions, develop effective teachers and education administrators, improve instructional methods and practices, administrative usages, enhance professional ideals and standards. While you go through this slide, you'll find that whatever it is required for the pedagogy of the current education system, I should involve some here and there. As far as the organization structure is concerned, we have an executive council at national level, and apart from this, we have some life members, some teachers as life members. Right now, some 78,000 teachers are member of ISTE. 350,000 students are there as ISTE members. More than 1,820 institutional members, 935 faculty chapters, and 1,035 student chapters who are actively involved some or the other activities. Major activities, as all the members I know, as I said, the members are involved in some of the activities. These are the few of the major activities which IST is right now linked on. Curriculum development and updating. AICT sponsors short-term training programs for engineering teachers and practicing professionals. Preparation of teacher manuals and other institutional resource materials under IST Resource Management Project. Preparations of LM, that is learning materials, for working professional in selected areas under ISTE working professional learning material. Then information technology oriented programs, project formulation and implementation appraisal, publication of newsletters, journals, handbooks, and various other magazines. At national level, we are involved in conduction of short-term training programs, and till date, some 10,121 short-term PA programs for Polytechnic Society and faculty has been conducted with, I mean, data statistics is there that how much participation, how much AICT linked is with us, and we are always continuously doing some sort of short-term training program. And this short-term PA program is always for the enhancement of skill of the teachers and, of course, for the career personality grooming for the students. There are some other listing how we are associated with the pedagogy. You see the conducted computer awareness program sponsored by the Department of Electronics, Government of India. And we were the pioneer organization who linked up somewhere with the AICT for the mass spreading of this ICT technology. We are also into some international collaboration. Here are some of the achievements. As you can find that we have represented India on Association of Engineering Education in South and Central Asia under the aegis of UNESCO. participated actively in the formulation and implementation of Canada-India Institutional Cooperation Project, a bilateral project between Government of India and Government of Canada, and 12 books have been published and disseminated, contributing significantly in the implementation of Canada-India Industrial Institute Linkage Project. This is also a bilateral project between Government of India and Government of Canada, and published and disseminated 45 learning materials in computer science and engineering under Project Impact, sponsored by the World Bank, SDC and Department of Electronics. There are some other achievements as far as STE is concerned for international collaborations. We have a sponsored project by Swiss Agency for Cooperation Development and AICT, and 22 books have been published. 25 more books are under different stages of preparation. Lab manuals and teacher manuals are also are under process. Membership of the World Federation of Association of College and Polytechnics, collaboration with International Association of Continuing Education Program, Commonwealth of Learning, Indo-UK REC project, conducted a study throughout document research and visits to institutions and submitted a report which will enable to revitalize links between National Institute of Technology, that is NITs, and universities in UK. There are some more, this thing, if I go on, it will take literally a very long time. So I'm just concluding, I'm just going through my slides in a quick way, that what are the publication, as you see that we are disseminating some newsletter. These are bi-monthly, I mean 6 issues in 1 year. Then there is a quarterly journal, Indian General for Technical Education. Then there is a handbook where you can have all the information, the various schemes of IST, list of members, section, committee members, chairman, student chapters, and what sort of activity they are doing it. Then we have students' primer, CIACP publications, Journal for Engineering Education. It is all available with us, which somehow is imparting for the enhancement of the skill, as well as the it is also giving a platform for a learning resource management. Now, this is the website. You can very well go through the website and you can find all the information there. What about the IST and skill enhancement and e-outreach project? As far as I understand that today we are here for digital learning, and IST is always gone ahead with some linkage with IST IGNU project. It is available at website. And IST IIT Bombay, there is a tie-up between IIT Bombay and IST for some e-outreach project. This can also be very well taken by, if you go through the IIT Bombay website, you can find all details there. Then, just coming to the today's topic, that what is virtual learning environment and how Indian Society of Technical Education can help somewhere. What at all is virtual learning environment? As a member of IST, what I can understand, what at all it is, it does not refer to any educational website, as the site simply includes static web pages. It is not restricted to systems, including some 3D or virtual reality technology. It is not synonymous to virtual campus, as virtual campus provides university courses covering a set of courses, while the name virtual learning environment does not restrict the scope to any level. Hence, it can be said the former, that is, a virtual campus is a subcategory of virtual learning environment. What at all is virtual learning environment then? Of course, it is a learning environment. It is a design or well-structured information space. It is a social space also. It is explicitly represented. Students at virtual learning management are not only as active, but they are actors also. Virtual learning environment are not restricted to distance education. A virtual learning environment integrates multiple tools. The virtual learning environment overlaps with the physical environment. Virtual learning environment do not only integrate a variety of software tools, but also integrate all the physical tools that can be found in a classroom. Most virtual learning environments include, first, a variety of non-computerized learning resources like concrete manipulation tools, instruments, books, etc. A variety of interactions that are not computer mediated, that is face-to-face discussion among students, lectures by the teacher, group discussion, etc., plus traditional media such as letters, TV, phone, and fax. A variety of activities that are not computer-based, that is field trips, role-playing, etc. IST can be a resource for analyzing the functional requirements. since